She found her lost twin after 35 years and told her something that changed their lives forever. When you meet twins on the street, you might imagine them in matching clothes and pulling off switcheroos. You know, all that stuff twins usually do. Yet Paula Bernstein and Elise Shine didn't have this twin experience. Thing is, the two girls were separated at birth and didn't have an opportunity to form a bond like no other. However, when they finally met, one of them had a crucial warning about their history she just had to share.
You know, we all have this fantasy or trying to find of having a twin out there, someone who's going to understand you perfectly, an ideal companion.
And maybe it truly is, but not for her. Her other half was out there somewhere, but Elise just wasn't aware of it. Paula Bernstein and Elise Shine were born in New York on October 9, 1968, and since that day they'd lived pretty much the same life without even knowing each other. Both girls had thin wrists and rounded hips, as well as an allergy to sulfa drugs. But there was something more than just their physical traits. Except for being spitting images of each other, the girls also had the same interests and hobbies. You see, they both were really creative personalities and studied film theory in college. What's more, they even made their own short films. Elise turned 35 and didn't even know she had a sister who lived in a completely different life. You might not believe it, but the girls grew up in the same city, yet both of their parents didn't tell them they had a sibling, so the twins never met. However, it's a pretty received opinion that twins have entirely the same lives. Elise lived alone, loved a good scotch on the rocks, and had dark wavy hair, while Paula got married, raised a child, and lived for Cosmopolitans. Since Elise knew she was adopted at 33, she decided to find her biological mother.
When I was in my early 30s, I began to have interest in my birth family and feel like there might be something more, but I didn't really know it was, and I wasn't expecting siblings.
After searching for a while, she found out that her mom was a Jewish 28-year-old woman when she welcomed her to this world, and the hits just kept coming. Elise also found out her mother never tried to find her daughter, which was daughters. Let's keep in mind that the woman still thought she was the only child at the moment. But then she received a certified letter from an adoption agency that turned her life upside down. The life-changing letter uncovered Elise had a twin and their mother was diagnosed with schizophrenia. This information simply paralyzed the woman, who wasn't ready for such a bombshell. "I had a zillion questions," Elise stated. "Just imagine you've been living your ordinary life, then out of the blue you find out you have a sibling who might be your spitting image." The woman had no clue whether she was an identical or fraternal twin, let alone why they were separated at birth. "I knew I had to find her," she recalled. At that moment, Elise lived her best life working as a filmmaker in Paris. She aimed to find her long-lost sister and immediately rushed to New York to rummage through public records. Luckily, a social worker from the adoption agency managed to track down her lost sister Paula. She was living a beautiful life with her husband and child in Brooklyn. And yes, she had no idea her double was about to find her soon.
"I never even contemplated the idea of a sibling, honestly. I never really thought about it."
But then the social worker revealed more information, which was devastating. She uncovered the reason why Elise and Paula were separated. You see, the two girls were part of a 1960s social experiment, likely one studying nature versus nurture. However, the social worker didn't know the details.
"It was disturbing, obviously, to feel as if I didn't know seek the truth about my origins, about my history, about our lives."
Not only had she just found out she had a sister all that time, but now she had to break such devastating news. Firstly, Paula spoke with Elise on the phone without breathing a word of the experiment. But when the two finally met at a cafe in 2004, she plucked up the courage to tell her all the truth. "We had 35 years to catch up on," Paula explained. "How do you start asking somebody, 'What have you been up to since we shared a womb together? Where do you start?'" Well, they figured it out. After getting to know each other, the twins were shocked they shared so many similarities. They both studied French, edited their school newspapers, and even fought both acne and depression. For them, it was a miracle to find each other, but soon after, the joy transformed into anger. When Elise found out about the experiment, she was at a boiling point and blew a fuse.
"For a twin study, felt that our lives had been orchestrated by these scientific researchers who put their scientific needs, research needs or desires, their career interests before the needs of us and the interests of us and the other twins."
"It was like something out of a movie. I broke down in tears," Paula admitted. "Nature intended for us to be raised together, so I think it was a crime we were separated." The frustrated sisters were determined to find out more and track down the doctors responsible. Their massive effort led them to New York psychiatrist Dr. Viola Bernard. The woman believed the girls would be able to find their own identities if separated, and even convinced the adoption agency to find them the different families. Yet Viola was no longer alive. Elise and Paula managed to find the other doctor responsible, Dr. Peter Neubauer. At first, he refused to talk to the women. Still, after some pushing, the NYU psychiatrist finally agreed to meet them at his Upper East Side apartment, provided their conversation was recorded.
Felt that we were facing the mad scientist himself, Frankenstein, and we were his lab rats who had come back to visit him. But he immediately tried to turn the tables around and said, "Oh, so you both dealt with depression. How was that? And what age was that?"
Dr. Neubauer supposedly studied the twins, comparing the ideas of nature versus nurture, which always ends up being an ethical travesty.
"What's really remarkable is that he expresses no remorse, even today."
The study's results will be kept secret at Yale University until 2066. You see, at that time, ethical standards were highly different and less strict than nowadays. But Elise and Paula didn't plan to stop digging through the aisles of libraries and public records. The sisters discovered Elise was initially named Marion and Paula was Jean. They'd also found out their mother, Lita Witt, was a voluntary patient at a psychiatric hospital at the time of their birth. The woman had attempted to kill herself. Unfortunately, Lita passed away in 1978 and never had an opportunity to see her daughters find each other. This fact specifically hurt Paula. It was all so much to comprehend. "When I look in the mirror, I not only see Paula, but Lita," Elise said. "I feel my existence is to pay homage to this woman who had a hard life," Elise continued. "The best of her lives on in us." Even though it's been a rocky road, the twins are profoundly grateful and happy they've found each other. The two even wrote a memoir together called Identical Strangers.